Hey guys, welcome back in CodeSphere. So today in this video, I will show you that how you can implement a custom fab menu for your Android app. So you can see on the screen when I will click on this. So you can see that there is three more custom buttons, and if I will click on it back again, so now it is closed. And when you will click any of them, so it will show a toast message, and now you can see that the menu is disclosed. The menu is closed. So today in this tutorial, I will show you that how we can do this. So without wasting time, let's start. So guys, what is the first thing that here we need to do is you can see that our parent layout is constant layout. And guys, here we will simply use a linear layout first thing. So simply use a linear layout and wrap content, fine. And then guys, we will simply give it orientation, and that will be vertical, fine, because the buttons will be in a vertical way. And after this guys, we will do is simply close it, fine. So after this guys, inside it, you have to use a floating action button. And simply use a floating action button, and that is going to be wrap content, fine. And the web size will be normal, fine. And then source will be guys, I already imported assets. So let me show you that I will use here is a IC keyboard. It is a sign for, it's like a arrow, yeah. So here you can see that it is showing IC keyboard arrow up. So I will use it IC underscore keyboard arrow up, fine. Then you can see here in this, fine. So guys, after this what I need to do is I have to give this ID, and ID is going to be FBA underscore main, fine. Then simply close it, fine. Then guys, after that we will fix it constant. So simply choose this linear layout, fine. Then let me fix it, that is yeah, it is not a complex step, just simply fix it, fine guys. Then what we need to do is you have to come inside this vertical linear layout, and here I will give it margin bottom will be 30 dp, fine. Then margin right, it will be 30 dp, same. So you can see that there is a little bit of margin. So after this guys, what you need to do, simply copy this floating action button, control plus c, and then we have to paste it three times, control plus v, then control plus v, then control plus v, fine. So now you can see that I have pasted it three times. So now we have four floating action button, but the problem is that all of them are of same size. So you have to change its size, and its size will be mini, fine. And I will change its ID also, so that will be one, fine. And I will also change its source, and this time I will make it camera. Photo camera black, yeah. I just want to show you the demo that you have to use different assets, so it will look better, fine. Again, you have to give it mini size, and guys, source will be, again, I will change it to shopping, fine. These are all assets that I have already implemented, and its ID will be fab2. Then again, its size is going to be mini. So now you can see that the buttons are looking small, but they are just coming in the left side. So I will give it the arrow airplane, fine. So now you can see that we have these different assets, and its ID will be fab3, fine guys. So guys, after this what you have to do here is you have to go inside this linear layout, fine. And here we will give it center gravity as a center horizontal, then it will make all of our buttons in the center, fine. Then you have to give the margin, and that is going to be 5 dp, fine. So you have to give it in all of the button margin, that will be 5 dp. Then after this is our button margin 5 dp, fine. So you can see that there is an equal space between our all of these buttons. So now you can see that our UI is looking quite good, fine. So guys, after this what here we need to do is that you have to go in this main activity.java, and guys, let me tell you one more important thing, that before starting this tutorial you have to add one more dependency in your Gradle build, and that is design support library. You can see that this is the design support library 28.0.0, fine. So you have to add this dependency and then click on the button Gradle sync. Then after this you will be able to implement this custom fab menu, fine. So after this guys, you have to come in this main activity.java, and here we have to declare variable for floating action button simply, and that will be f main, fine. Then f1, fine. Then f2, then f3, fine guys. So now you can see that we have total four buttons, and now we have total four variables, fine. So after this you have to declare a float for the translation, we will need it later. So simply give it name translation, and it will be y axis, fine. So it will be for the easiness. Then after this, we have to give value ended F. Fine. Then guys, what you have to do is we need a boolean to check that the menu is open or not. Fine. So simply write menu open and we will make it false by default. Simply give it false. Fine. Then guys, what you have to do is you have to come inside this onCreate method, and here you have to simply create a method, and that will be menu, I think, show menu. Fine. That is a method, and now it is showing red because we have not created it. I will create it in just few seconds. So click on this red bulb, fine, and then create method show menu. So now you can see that we have got this method. Fine. Then what you have to do inside this method is you have to, first thing that what we are going to do is simply write f main, and we will give reference. So find view by id r dot id dot, that will be f main. Fine. Then semicolon, then f1, then equals to find view by id r dot id dot f1. Fine. Then semicolon, then f2, that is also going to be find view by id r dot id dot f2. Fine. Then f3, so that will be again find view by id r dot id dot f3. Fine. Now semicolon. So guys, after this what we have to do is that we will fix its alpha. Fine. So simply write f1 and dot set alpha, and that will be 0f. Fine. Then guys, f2, then dot set alpha, and that will be again 0f. Fine. Oops. Then guys, after this you have to go for the third one, then again set alpha, and it will be again 0f. Fine. So now you can see that we have fixed the alpha. Now after this guys, what we will do is we will fix a translation. In that translation, our videos, our buttons, floating action buttons will move, will appear. Fine. So actually we are fixing the translation. So how can we do this? Simply write f1 dot set translation. Fine. And it will be for y, and you have to simply give it translation y axis, then f2, then dot set translation, then again translation y axis, then f3. Fine. Then again dot set translation, that will be translation y axis. Fine. So it will make our buttons in a single row. Fine. Then after this we have to implement set on click listener method for every button. Fine. So when the user will click on the f main dot set on click listener method, so inside it we will code that what will happen when the user will click on that button. Fine. So guys, after this you can see that I have implemented this set on click listener method. So inside it, first of all we will check that if it is open or not. So if menu open, then what we will do, we will make it, we will close it. So simply create a method close menu, then semicolon. So you can see that it is showing red because we have not created it, but we will create it in just few seconds. Fine. So after this what you have to do is you can see that this is our second main method. Fine. So it is also showing red because we have not created it, so we will create it in few seconds. Fine. So guys, now it's time to go outside this, and you can also create it by clicking on this method close menu, then create method close menu in main activity.java. Fine. And then after this again click on this open menu, and this time we should get the method also. Click on this red bulb and again create method open menu, then main activity. Fine. So guys, now we have two methods and we have to code inside these two methods. Fine. But before implementing it, we have to copy this we have to implement set on click listener method for other buttons. So simply write f1 new on click listener method, and inside it guys we will simply show a toast message, toast message, and that will be f1 is clicked. Fine. Then guys, simply after this you have to copy this code from here, and simply copy it, then paste it three times. Fine. Then change its name, make it f2, and make this one f3. Fine. Let me delete this one because it is extra. So dot, now it's fine. So now you can see that we have implemented set on click listener method on all four buttons. So guys, now it's time to come inside this open menu method, and now here we will set translation. Fine. So we will make it visible or invisible. So what is the first thing that we are going to do is that we will not change the boolean state, we will let it remain as it is. Fine. So simply write menu open, and then equals to, not equals to, menu open, then semicolon. Fine. So guys, after this here you have to, first thing that we will do is that we will change the background, the image resource of the main fab main button. Fine. So simply write set image droppable, and image resource will be r dot droppable dot, and that will be IC underscore keyboard downside. So when the user will click on it, it will change the arrow. Fine. So after this, guys, you have to simply write is F1 dot, that will be animate, then dot, then this time we'll fix is a translation, then animation, then translation, that will be 0, then F, fine, then again dot alpha, not start, we will need alpha, then it will be 1F, then dot, then we will fix interpolator. So guys, for inside this set interpolator, what we need is we need one more. So what here we need to do is you have to simply declare interpolator. So simply write over shoot interpolator, fine, then interpolator equals to new. Now we will initialize it, fine, then over interpolator, then semicolon. So you have to do this, you have to do this step. Then guys, after this you have to paste that interpolator inside it, then write dot, and then guys, after this we will simply write start. But we have to set the duration, and that will be 300 and it is milliseconds. Then after this simply start. Now you can see that is a code enough. So after this you have to simply copy this codes, because simply copy this codes and paste it 3 times, fine. Then after this you have to simply change this F2 then F3, fine guys. So now you can see that this is a code, and after this you have to simply copy this code from this open menu, and you have to go inside this close menu and simply paste it, fine. And after this guys, you will have to change this enable draw resources, and we will again make it upside arrow, done. Then here what you have to do is instead of this 0f, here we will give the translation y-axis in all three. So write translation y-axis, then after this you have to make this 0f, so simply make it 0f. And yes guys, so that is all for this tutorial, and it's time to run this app and see is it working or not. So in case if you get any error, then let me know in comment section, I will try to reply next 24 hours. But guys, that is not a complex coding, so I think you should not have any error, fine. So now you can see that our Gradle build is running. So as you can see that the app is running and there is no error, and now the activity is launched. So guys, after this you can see that this is an arrow size and it is showing upward when I will click on this button. So you can see that we have these three more custom fab buttons, and if I will click on it, so it will come back, fine. And when I clicked on it, so you can see that this arrow is changed, that we are changing here. And if I will click on this camera, so it will show a toast message, F1 is clicked. If I will click on this, it is also show the toast message. So you can see that our code is working absolutely fine. But guys, the problem is that if a user will click on this button, so this menu should be closed, but it is not closing. So what here we can do is, guys, you have to do is, that is a very simple process. After this toast message, you have to implement that method, close menu in all of these three buttons, fine, close menu, and again inside it, close menu. And after this, when I will run this app, so whenever user will click on any of the button, it will simply close that menu, fine. So now you can see that the app is installed successfully, and now the activity is launching. So this time guys, when I will click on this button, so it will simply close the menu, fine. So now you can see that it is working absolutely fine, there is no kind of error. And guys, I will also provide its source code in the description box, you can check it out. We have an official website, courseware1.blogspot.com. So I hope you like this tutorial, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.